original motivation was to provide a lively introduction to the most important features of MATLAB for students, researchers and practitioners. But we also wanted to provide a compact reference to MATLAB. And this second point is important because if you look at the complete PDF documentation for the current version of MATLAB, it runs to about 10,000 pages. So there's a need for a more concise, accessible reference that you can hold in your hand.
Yeah, and I would maybe add that we weren't trying to write a numeric analysis textbook. We're really writing a user guide with MATLAB Guide. So we're teaching you how to use MATLAB, not the algorithms inside MATLAB. So we're teaching you how to drive the car and not showing what's under the hood.
The third edition reflects 12 years of updates, and since the second edition came out, updates to MATLAB, and these include major updates to the graph 14 and also to the symbolic map toolbox. A number of other changes, figures are now printed in color, so we can now show how color can be exploited in MATLAB. We have a number of asides in gray boxes scattered throughout the text, and these sort of add to the text with discussions of related topics such as anonymous functions, reproducible research and color maps. And there are four new chapters on the parallel computing toolbox is covered now, on object-oriented programming, on graphs using the new MATLAB graph class, and also handling large data sets. Des, any other new features in the third edition?
Yes, we're also covering important new MATLAB data types. For example, there's graphs and categorical arrays and tall arrays and tables and timetables. We've had more content now on MATLAB workflow, which includes live scripts and also the live editor, which is a new environment for editing and running MATLAB code. It allows you to put the results, including the graphics, have those inserted into the code. And what we hope the readers get out of the book is our own personal view of what we think is important about MATLAB, and that's based on many years of experience. In fact, we began using MATLAB in 1984, before it was even a commercial product. In terms of facilities, we've also made a web page for the book, so that makes available all the example programs that we've written. We've been very careful to make the index as thorough as possible, and we also have a glossary. So if you're wanting to dip in and look at certain topics, then we're trying to make that as easy as possible to do, and that's both for beginners and experts. We think we'll find that useful. The book begins with a very brief hands-on tutorial. So you can just type in a few commands and get a whirlwind tour showing you some of the facilities that, that MATLAB can offer. And towards the end of the book, we have a set of case studies. So these are more significant, large-scale scientific computing problems, and we show how we would approach their solution using MATLAB code.
Well, to me, three things come to mind and stand out as regards that comparison. So the first one is that MATLAB is self-contained. Once you've installed it, you don't have to download any of the packages, you can just run it as it is, and everything's there that you need. Secondly, it's very mature. MATLAB's been around more than 30 years, so there's 30 years of development there. In the numerically stable algorithms and really everything within MATLAB is very mature. And also, the MathWorks managed to retain excellent backward compatibility. So if you install today's MATLAB, code you wrote 10, 20, 30 years ago, have a good chance of still running fine without any changes, or if they do need changes, they'll probably be quite small changes. So that backward compatibility is a really important thing for those of us who are long-term users. Anything else, Des, comes to mind?
Yeah, I would say the syntax that MATLAB uses is very close to the kind of pseudocode that we use to describe algorithms. So what we write down on paper can be very readily transferred into MATLAB style programming. But having said that, there are of course many commonalities between these different packages, and some of the basic tools and skills that you need can very, very easily transferred. So building up expertise in MATLAB makes you very attractive to all sorts of employees or employers, because those kind of programming skills are relevant in many different contexts.
Well, I suppose we've made it to the third edition of MATLAB Guide, and we're still on speaking terms, so I think that shows it's been working pretty well.
Yeah, I would add that I think we tend to be more frank with each other than we would be with other co-authors. So in a sense, that makes process it produces better outputs. We're somewhat competitive, but also helpful towards each other. So I think the end result benefits from that.